Hello everyone, my name is Mandy Lynn. I'm the author of the young adult novel Essence, and today we're going to be talking about what you can do to write dialogue in your novel and to make it sound natural. So I actually, you know, wrote down a few little tips and tricks that I will now go through. So the first thing you want to do is just kind of observe people around you, listen to how they talk, and observe different speech patterns. People who live in different areas have different accents and they have different ways of talking. I have apparently a little bit of a Boston accent, so I say things a little bit differently, and I may add the word wicked, which I don't like to add the word wicked, but I have noticed myself doing that sometimes, and it's a little annoying. I also develop a southern accent sometimes, I don't know why, but just listen to how people talk, that way you can write your characters with realistic speech patterns. When you're writing dialogue, you don't want to give too much at once, because if you have this giant paragraph, it just kind of becomes boring and people won't want to read it and they'll lose track of it, and it's just not the best. You want to mix things up. So speaking of mixing things up, you can break up dialogue with action. You know, if a character needs to give a great big gigantic speech, you can break that up by, you know, having them do things like, if they're talking, break it up by saying, oh, then all of a sudden they started playing with something in front of them or whatever. Just to make it a little more interesting, that way it's not this gigantic speech, add in like, because when people talk, they do things. They don't just sit there and talk and talk and talk. Obviously, I tend to talk with my hands sometimes. And so you can add that to a character if they talk with their hands. Write that in the book. And you don't want to overdo dialogue tags, which is, you know, he said, she said, they did this, that. You don't always need it, especially if it's a quick back and forth conversation between two characters, because if you just, you know, indent and start a new paragraph every time, it's obvious that it goes from one character talking to the other. You don't need, like, oh, Bilbo started talking, Bilbo said this, then Frodo said that. You don't need all that. You need it at the beginning, but not after a while. Observe how other books do it, and then you'll kind of get a feel. And that's actually another tip, to just read and see how they do dialogue in other books, because obviously when you read a book, you aren't going to read a book and observe and notice the dialogue, because that's the whole point. You don't want it to be obvious that they're doing dialogue a certain way. It's supposed to be this seamless sort of thing. So read other books and see how they do it. You don't want to overuse profanity and slang, because you may think it's a good idea, but it can be sometimes distracting to a reader. You want to use it if that's how the character is going to talk, but you don't want to, like, have it every other word be profanity or slang. It just gets confusing. A lot of southern books use kind of slang. Obviously the characters are from a southern area where they do use a lot of slang and stuff like that, but you don't want to overwhelm a reader, because then it just becomes difficult to read something. And the last tip would be punctuation. And this, you have to figure out how to punctuate for dialogue. You need a comma, then the two little quotation thingies, and then he said or whatever. It's not period, quotation, blah blah blah. It's comma, quotation, blah blah blah. Obviously I'm not gonna give a whole lesson on this, but it's very important that if you're using dialogue to learn punctuation correctly. I can't imagine writing a novel without dialogue, because that's gonna be a lot of things you have to avoid, which is everything. It's gonna be a very internal novel. A very boring novel if you don't have dialogue. So learn how to use dialogue, punctuation, and the world will start to make a little more sense. So I hope this video helped you guys, and now you will know how to use dialogue in your novels. If you have requests for any other videos, let me know in the comments below. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.